Good morning, everyone.
Queen Cleo.
Just come in to give you some inspiration. I'm so happy. I'm happy every day, but especially when feast days are this week or coming, a feast day, the Lord's feast days in the Bible, what we are supposed to celebrate. So Feast of Atonement. Is Tuesday sundown, we will be fasting, afflicting our souls. And it's because of, you know, God was afflicted, Jesus was afflicted, you know, during the time where he was crucified. So it's geared to what I learned.
It's geared to that, to afflict your
soul. So, you know, do something for him because he did so much for us. He died for our of our sins, so he did a lot. He went through a lot.
You know, he was talked about. He was spit on. He was, you know,
marked.
He was beaten. He did all that for us. You know, because at any time his Father, God, he could have came down and stopped everything, but it was for our remission of our sins, to cleanse us, because you know
you have to. And Jesus took the place of the sacrificial lamb. So we don't have to do that anymore, because he is the first fruits. He is the lamb.
He took the
place of an actual lamb in the Bible. So I'm so happy that we get to experience atonement. This year has been our first
year
experience
Passover. We experienced Pentecost.
Feast of Trumpets. We are now experiencing Atonement, and then we have the Feast of, I want to say Tabernacles,
but before that it's the
Feast of
Dwell in Booths. Yes, so I'm so happy. I'm so proud of me and my family coming into the knowledge. Once again, I will say I came into the knowledge by God and my husband, and had some time with it, but once I knew in my heart that it was something that God wanted me to do, everything stopped. I stopped eating pork. I stopped eating crab, lobster, shrimp. I stopped holidays, period. Last year was my last year celebrating. I don't celebrate any holiday. That is any holiday. Christmas, Easter.
Any holiday.
Anything that the world celebrates as a holiday. Or a day, you know, like Valentine's Day, I don't celebrate that day. I can show my husband every day I love him. I don't have to amplify it because those are pagan days.
Rituals are behind
Easter, Christmas.
You know, I'm not going to debate once
again. I tell everyone, you know, I'm not debating because this is in the Bible what we don't post consume.
Or eat, you know. Some Christians,
Roman Christianity,
will tell you,
"Oh, it's been done away with." But the Old Testament and the New Testament are together in a book. You have to read the Old Testament, and then you have to read the New Testament.
So you cannot
do away with one part of the Bible. God came to uphold the law. He didn't come to change anything that was in the first part of the Bible. Jesus did not. He came to fulfill, you know, prophecy with, you know, him and his Father. Well, actually, what the Father wanted, God. So, nothing has changed other than that he took the place of the sacrificial lamb. So, if you're a Hebrew, well, we're all Hebrew Israelites. But if you just come into the knowledge, you don't have to sacrifice an animal. Don't do it. Don't sacrifice an animal. Please don't.
Because they did that back in the Bible times, but
we don't have to do it because Jesus, when he
came, when he died, he took the place
of the sacrificial lamb.
And this is all in the Bible.
You can read it. Genesis, through Malachi, you can go beyond that. In Leviticus, you can
go
in Deuteronomy. You can go in
a lot of places in the Bible.
A lot of the books, they are saying the same thing, but they're saying it in their way. The prophets are saying it. The apostles are saying it. they're saying it in a different way, but it's all going together. Their stories are going together. So just like God, you know, in the Bible, if you have one person saying, oh, well, this happened, don't like go off of what they're saying. But you have multiple people, like in life, that's like someone spreading nasty rumors. You know what I'm saying? Today, like, one person can say it, but if it amplifies to, like, you know, two or three, everybody believes it, even if it's not true. But in the Bible, when it says that two or more witnesses, he wants you to listen.
And it is true, because in the Bible,
they tell you, you know, everybody, not everybody, but people bear false witness. Like, they bear false witness when Jesus was crucified. They picked
a thief over Jesus just because they didn't believe
that he was God's son, the son of God. They took sins, they took curses on them, themselves, and their children just so Jesus would die.
And that's a horrible
thing, to put curses on a child that don't know better. And a mother is, you know, and to this day, it happens. You know, generational curses are real, real. I have experienced and saw generational curses in my family, and I had to pray against that, period. Alcoholism, drugs, just bad stuff, you know, stealing, all that. I saw it all. I'm not perfect, but I know I didn't want to be that type of person. My family, I'm not talking down on them, because I love them. Everybody has to go through and remove these spirits off of them, because there is spirits that don't want you to succeed, but we serve a God, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, Jacob, that they're not allowed to touch you unless God wants. Everybody, every spirit, Belial, the devil, he cannot do anything unless he has permission from God. God sits high and he looks low. So you have to speak to him, you have to trust in him every day. Every day I wake up, I'm talking to him first. Every day I go to sleep, I'm talking to him first.
When I move my car, when I'm,
you know, in business with my boutique, I take everything to him in prayer. He's over my business. He's over my life. He is my king, my everything. So for the people that are not, you know, oh, I don't believe God, I pray for you, because God is a jealous God. And he sees and he knows everything.
So you're not believing in him,
you're disrespecting.
Because how do you think you
got it? God created the world in 7 days.
6 days. He rested on the seventh, and that was the Sabbath.
So that's why we celebrate Sabbath on the seventh day, because God created the world in 6 days.
So God created
us. He created
animals. Oh,
don't
quote me on that.
Then
he created animals, and then he created the woman. That's how the lineup went. And you can read in the Bible how Adam
and Eve were created.
So, for
someone to say that he's not real, for someone to say that they don't believe, that's a disrespect
to God.
You need to, like, find him. You need to pray. Because there are things are going to come against you if you're not in line with what God wants you to do. If you're not following his precepts. If you're not, you know, following his laws, his statutes, the commandments, he
expects us to keep it. It has not been nailed
to the cross. The commandments you have to do. Thou shalt not commit adultery. You cannot go into another man or woman's house and sleep with their husband or wife. You cannot go in your neighbor's house and mess with their husband or wife. Or you can't take any of their property. Or you cannot talk trash about your neighbor. Love that neighbor. Honor that mother and that father. You cannot curse your mama out. You cannot curse your father out. You can be upset with them, but you have to pray. God say honor that mother and that father. He didn't tell you how to, but you got to do it. You cannot do things that are not of him. You cannot steal. You cannot kill. You cannot bear false witness, lying on others. You cannot do that and expect to be blessed by him. Because God is forgiving God, but he will teach you a lesson.
It's not that easy. Oh,
all I have to do is say I'm saved. You got to put in the work. You got to do the laws, the statutes, and commandments. And the world has been
Whew. Had to take a breath.
In today's world, we're serving another form of religion. This is Roman Christianity.
Religion. This is not the religion that
God gave us. We are Hebrew Israelites. We have been scattered. We have been, our eyes have been covered. And for me to, you know, and my family eyes to be uncovered, to like celebrate
and love God the way
He wants is amazing. It brought me to tears. I've always cried to God because I always felt Him around me. And I felt that He has always been there. And He didn't have to do anything. But just to feel His spirit, just to feel His guardian angels around you is beautiful.
And I'm put here to
spread the knowledge, the wisdom of God, fearing Him, that I have to do this. I can't hold it. I want to get through to somebody who needs this
to survive. There
are as many people out there that are in crisis because they don't know God. But if you know Him, you know that He loves us and He will never forsake us. We will go through trials and tribulations. We'll go through hardships, but God will bring us out on top. Every time you get the victory, every time you will be restored in His name, He wants you to love Him the way He loved us. He wants you to
praise Him the way He loves
to praise us to the world. You gotta love Him. You gotta show love for Him to the world. Because we are in the world, but we're not of the world. I am not of the world. I live in the world. I live in captivity. Being captive because we're not in our homeland. We're not in Israel. That is the homeland, Israel.
And this is not something that,
oh, she's going crazy. What she done got into? I got into God. And I'm not changing it. I changed my whole life because God died for me. Jesus died for me and you.
That's a lot.
And I would die for Him.
I will. Like,
have that mentality, like you will lay your life down for Him because He laid
His life down for you. He wants our love, He wants
our commitment, He wants to know that we are all in, and I'm all in. Anything can go.
What can't go,
and what I won't allow to go, is God. And I'm going to speak the gospel, I'm going to spread the knowledge. The days are we're celebrating. The man-made holidays, no, we have to come away from that. We have to celebrate the feast days.
Go to Leviticus 23rd chapter, read the whole
chapter. And He will tell you what days that He wants us to celebrate.
He will tell you the feast days. He doesn't say anything about Easter. Because if we're serving Easter, that is a whole
other conversation.
You're not serving God.
Sunday worship, no, 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 no. We don't worship on Sunday. Sunday is the first day.
We worship on
Sabbath is Friday, sundown, Saturday, sundown. It's only one God. He only wanted us to follow one religion. All other religions that you're following. I know people love, you know, to celebrate other things.
She scared me. I know they love to,
you know what I'm saying? I'm just spiritual. And not talking about anybody, because when you don't know God, you're lost. But worshiping false gods, He will kill you.
It's God.
It's Jehovah. It's Yah. Other names, other gods, is not of Him. Other religions, no, 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 it's not of Him. Not of Him.
You have to celebrate
the feast days.
Because God has a
law that we still have to uphold. We're under the covenant that we have with Him, that He made with Israel.
And we, our ancestors
disrespected Him. They weren't listening. They did a lot of things that angered God. So God scattered everyone.
But now when your eyes
are open, you have to allow God to work and lead you. And I just always say pray, you know what I'm saying, for understanding of everything, because it's not on your understanding, it's through
God that you
understand.
Ask Him for the knowledge,
the wisdom,
to, you know, go through life in the way he wants. Go through life by praying
and asking God to lead you to the right people, the right job, the right, you know what I'm saying, your home. You take everything to God in prayer. Everything is to God in prayer. You don't sit around and think you're better. You don't gossip. You don't spread lies about others. You don't make someone feel like they're not worthy of living. There's a lot of like wicked things that are going on where the suicide rate is high in school. The children are killing themselves because someone said that they're not pretty, they're fat, they're ugly, you're too black, you're too light. It's just a lot of diminishing of a human being. There's a lot of disrespect that's going on. God said it will be if you don't follow his laws, that he was disrespected
in the Bible times, and he's being disrespected
in today's world.
You know, God created us to
do his works.
It's not the other way around.
We're serving him.
A lot of times everybody
wants to do what they want to do. They don't want to serve God. They don't want to worship on the Sabbath. They don't want to do sundown to sundown. They want to go out and do whatever they want to do. But when I decided to do what God wanted me to do, my life got 100% better. I don't have any drama. I have peace in my life.
And another thing with the
commandment, fornication.
And I'm not
better than anybody. But once I learned that you cannot have sex outside of marriage, I stopped.
I took it to God in prayer, and he
led me to be married.
And I'm proud of it.
And I'm so much better about everything in life. I walk different. I talk different. I feel different. Because I have his spirit. I have his love to guide me. So if I have this in me, in the knowledge, I'm going to spread it. I'm going to tell, you know, others about it. We have to stop this. We have to stop celebrating and worshiping other gods. We have to stop fornicating.
We have to stop
committing sins.
Going into other marriages and tearing
it up. No, you can't do that.
And wives, you have to pray for
your marriage. And husbands, you have to pray.
Temptation is everywhere. But you have to let
God lead you.
You got to come away from
disrespect of celebrating
Christmas, celebrating Thanksgiving, celebrating Easter. Oh, it's for the
family. No, because once you leave this earth,
well, no, let me rephrase that.
Once
you go to sleep, and your time,
you know, to sleep until God returns,
you have to be ready,
and you have to die in Christ.
You have to die in Christ. You got to be in line
with what he wants you to do to be in the first resurrection.
You have to be forgiven. Because we all, you got to.
I mean, if you don't get in the first resurrection.
Sorry. Resurrection, you're going to be
judged in the second one.
And this is all Bible. This is
all scripture. This is nothing that I'm making up because she want to be famous or she just want to talk. No, I want to talk about the love I have and the goodness of God. And learning this has been an amazing
feeling. At first, I felt confused,
lost, but God gave me the knowledge. He gave me the wisdom, and he gave me peace.
So I'm just so happy
to spread the knowledge, and I'm not going to, you know, keep it to myself or be scared to talk about it, because I know I have God on my side, the hedge of protection surrounding me. He's allowing me to tell you guys that. We have to come away from our wicked ways. We have to come away from celebrating holidays that have nothing to do with God. God wasn't born on the 21st of December.
He wasn't. There's no record of him being born
in the Bible. So we can't make up of a day for him.
And there's going to be a great debate.
You know, no, you don't know what you're talking about. Yes, I do. Reading the Bible, there's no date. You can't put a date on when he was born. And you can't put a date when he died.
He didn't die on Good Friday.
Or he didn't rose on Sunday.
You have to go into the Bible
and you have to
take it for what it is.
God is just not going to have a big sign. Listen, you have to go in and put line upon line, precept upon precept. That means the Old Testament is still valid as well as the New. So the New Testament...
New Testament Christians, that's wrong.
We are still under the covenant that God made. The covenant Moses speaks of in the Bible, the first Genesis.
We're still under that covenant.
We still have to follow the Ten Commandments. The laws, statutes, we still have to celebrate feast days.
We still have to celebrate feast days. Everything is the
same, other than we don't sacrifice the lamb. You don't have to kill a lamb. You don't have to smear it on your doorpost. You don't have to smear it on your door to your home.
Because God has told us from the beginning of what He expects out of us. He is our Father. We have to follow Him.
We didn't get in the world just, we just poop. He made
man. He made
animals. He made women.
So we have to take everything
that we see in the world and look, how did I do this? How did I do that? Oh, I know, because God allowed me to. Babies being born, God allowed it. Sickness, God allowed it. Someone dies, God allowed it. Everything is allowed by Him. No one can make a move. God knows your thoughts. He knows your feelings. He know, I know Cleo was going to make this video about me today. He knew it. Cause
I did it. He is over everything.
And once you learn that God is over everything, you will hearken your heart to His word. You will do His works.
It's not to say that you're better than anybody,
but you're coming away from all the wicked things of the world.
You want to be separated. Ye be separated. We are a
peculiar people.
We have a diet.
We don't supposed to consume a pig that eats everything, that cleans the world up. That eats
unspeakable things.
You putting that in your body.
We don't. We
are not supposed to eat crab, lobster, shrimp that love. You know, I used to love, but now I don't. I love God, so I put all that away. I don't eat lobster. I don't eat shrimp. I don't eat crab. I don't. Whatever God tells me not to touch, I'm not touching. Whoever God takes away, then I release them. I don't hate them, but I'm not going to disrespect Him, because I fear God to the point
where I don't make any moves
without consulting Him.
I take everything
into consideration.
So I just want you guys
to know that you are blessed, you are highly favored. You have a Father up above that loves you and wants you to come away from this life. I know it was tradition. I know you celebrated Christmas for years. I know you celebrated Easter for years.
But
I came away from it.
It's disrespect to Him. And I'm not debating.
This is not for a debate. I'm not debating. I'm reading. I'm telling you what's in the Bible. I don't want to debate.
But the Ten Commandments
are still in effect.
So if you're eating
pork, if you're eating
crab, lobster, shrimp,
if you're celebrating holidays, you're disrespecting God.
And I'm not debating
it at all. No, I'm not.
Because I'm speaking the
knowledge that I know, that I receive. And I'm speaking His gospel. And I'm not going to debate about it. I'm not going to feel bad about it. Because God has always been there for me. He has always showed me His favor. He has, you know, His faithfulness to me.
And it's time for me to be faithful to God. It's time for me
to spread His gospel. It's time for me to show Him that I'm faithful
of the knowledge. I'm faithful of a child, God. I am a Hebrew Israelite.
I am.
And I stand with the other Hebrew Israelites.
I'm separated because of what God wants.
I'm not of the world. I'm not going crazy. I'm very educated. I'm very alive. I'm not in a daze. I have came out of the daze. I came out better. God has uncovered myself, my husband, my children. He uncovered us, our eyes. And now we see him for who he is.
We see the truth. We see the lies.
We see the disrespect of what our ancestors did.
He is the Most High God.
And I stand with God, not the world.
And I'm happy. I'm blessed.
He's doing a lot for me with my business. I debuted my website, Styles 3P. That's lowercase style 3P.
.net.
You can go and look at my clothing. I sell women clothes. So if you're interested in any women clothes, it's for any occasion. If you're going to worship on Sabbath, if you're, you know, just want to go out on a date with your husband or your wife, I'm going to get intimate clothes too. So I will be linking my website and my bio. But I am blessed. I'm highly favored. And I want to spread the gospel this morning. I wanted you to learn about Jesus, learn about what he stands for yourself. Go in the Bible. This is him.
This is not of me.
I don't want any credit. I don't want any fame. I want to spread the gospel, what God intended me to. This is not a how people say, oh, you want to be famous, or this is just for you to get. No, not for clout. I serve God. I serve Jesus. I serve everything that's of him. Nothing that I want. Nothing the world can give me that God hasn't given me, gave me.
He has replaced. He has
removed. He has refreshed me. I am Hebrew Israelite, and I'm Queen Cleo, and I want you guys to have an amazing morning. I want you guys to seek God diligently, like I have. I want you to celebrate the
true Sabbath.
Friday sundown to Saturday sundown, get a Bible. If you don't have a church, I have several pastors that you can follow. And also our Pastor Johnson.
He is an amazing teacher. He is from Florida.
Fort Lauderdale. His name is Pastor Johnson. Bethel House of God. I've been there, me and my husband, my children. We had a wonderful time. We also follow Brother Bowie. He is in Chicago, Riverdale. You can follow him at IOG, Brother Bowie. Wonderful people. Also, Biblical T. She is a smart woman, a woman, sorry. Biblical T, she's on YouTube. And also, I want to shout out the YOLO Show. She's a beautiful person. You can follow her as well. So those are the people that I'm following. Those are the people that God led me to. The YOLO Show, thumbs up. Biblical T, thumbs up. Thumbs up to Pastor Johnson. You have been a great teacher. You have been a wonderful teacher. We are thankful for you.
All love.
We had a wonderful time at your church, and we will be back. We just don't know when. And all praise goes to the Most High God for leading us to... you know, you, Pastor Johnson, Bowie, Israel God, YOLO Show, Biblical T. Just giving some shout outs. But the most shout out, the most praise goes to the Most High for bringing us these people.
The knowledge to us and bringing us people that are into the
knowledge. And
I thank you. I praise you. The Most High God, I will
serve you, Messiah. I thank you and I love you. And I want you guys to have an amazing Monday. Start your day with God and ending your day with God. So this is Queen Cleo signing off.